Now we see the sawtooth wave, and here is one period of such a wave, negative x from negative pi to zero, that's this part, and then negative x plus pi on zero to pi, that's this part over here. Okay, so maybe it has a little bit of an edge to it, we'll see. So let's compute the fifth degree Fourier polynomial. The integrals involved in finding that are very time consuming. So for example, A4 would be this integral here, but then when you put that in and break it up piecewise like you'd have to do, then you got a parts problem here and an integral by parts problem there. So that's going to get very time consuming because you're going to have to do, for a fifth degree, you got 10 things to compute plus the original A0. So if we want to get somewhere with our music examples, we're going to have to figure out these integrals some other way than by hand, and we're going to use our integral program in our calculator. So what do we put in there? Negative x on x greater than or equal to negative pi times x less than 0 times y2. I'll explain that in a second. So this is your interval. That's an and, means it has to be both this and that in order for this to have this value. Plus, so it'll be 0 when x is outside of that. Then you're going to add on, here's your other piece, and here's your interval, less than pi but greater than or equal to 0, and again times y2, I'll explain that in a second. So this is your piecewise defined function. If this is 0, then you know you're in here. If you're in neither of those, then the whole function zeroes out. Now how are you going to get this y2 thing right here? That's by going to vars and then arrow over to yvars and function, and you'll see y2 in the list, and you pick it. Okay, and that goes here and here. So y2 right now equals 1 because we're going to do a0 first, so the 1 won't affect anything. Now what you want to do is turn the graph of y2 off by moving over the equals and enter. So here you're here, that's on right now. You want to move the cursor over that equals and hit enter so that it's blank like that, because we don't want that showing up on the graph. Now we're going to check our formula here in our y1. So graph to check it. Okay, so we graph this, and sure enough it checks out. That's the sawtooth wave. And why are we putting that y2 in there? Because we're going to have to be multiplying the f of x by cosine of kx and sine of kx to integrate to find the rest of the Fourier coefficients. And we don't want to be typing that inside here all the time, so I put it in. We're going to put it in y2. Okay, so now we find all the coefficients. Here they all are. A0 is this integral here. That's the definition. Make sure y2 is equal to 1 in the calculator. Run the integral program, Simpson 100. And then you're going to multiply the answer by 1 over 2 pi, because that's out here. So don't forget that. So you run the program, it comes out, then you put times, and then you see this answer here, and you put 1 over 2 pi, put the 2 pi in parentheses, and you get this number, and that's A0. Now you're going to go to A1. Okay, you need the cosine to be in there. So change the y2 in the calculator to cosine x. Then run the program. Take your answer, multiply by 1 over pi, not 1 over 2 pi, 1 over pi, turns out 0.0105. Okay, keep on going like that. As you can see, B1 has the sine in there, so you're changing the y2 to sine. You run it, you get that e-15 type of thing, that means it's 0. So you get that, and you keep on going. I'm just going to scroll here. keep on getting those coefficients the same way. You know, be careful to put in the right y2 every time. Otherwise you get the wrong answer. Run some of these to verify these answers. And then you get all your coefficients and you write them all down. Turns out that all the a's turned out to be 0.0105. There's your a0. And here was the b1s. Interesting that this one has a very, what we're going to call later, a loud coefficient. And pretty loud compared to these. These are soft. These are going to be loud when we play them. And then we wrote down the F5 from all those coefficients, and then the zeros, we took those out. And so here's F5 right there. So now you're going to check it. Put F5 into Y3. Have Y1 and Y3 on to graph and Y2 off. And here's the graph you get. It's looking pretty good. Okay, that's a real good fit there. It could be better, of course, and the better it is, you know, the more higher degree you have of the Fourier polynomial, the more it's tight to this. It's going to be going like this. Okay, now we're going to go to the player site and put in the coefficients to listen. So we go to that site that we have on the worksheet and in the previous video. And I put in 1.576 into here, but it chopped it off to 1. So evidently 1 or maybe negative 1 is the highest and lowest it can go. So in a musical terms, that'd be like you're playing something and you want to hard limit it, which means chop off the sound once it hits a barrier. And that's what's going on there. That 1 sound is being chopped off at 1. That's okay. It's close enough for us. It'll sound the same. Okay, when you put in the numbers, all these numbers here for your A's and here's your B's, don't forget to hit enter after each one. Somehow it doesn't register into the site unless you hit enter. Okay, so then put in the cosine wave in wave 2. Wave 2, put in the cosine, and that's just your 0 plus 1 cosine. So you got the 0 and you got the 1 on the A0 and A1. Now play and switch back and forth between wave 1, which is a sawtooth, and wave 2 is a cosine to compare. Alright, so now you put your coefficients in, and we're ready to go. I'm going to go over here and turn the sound on. And there's your sawtooth wave. It has the it's an octave up for reasons I'm going to explain further on in the video. Here's your plain, very innocent sounding cosine wave. Here's your sawtooth. Has a little bit of an attitude. And that's because I'll explain why in the rest of the video. So you notice that the sawtooth is more edgy. It has more character. And also it has harmonics that bring out a pitch that's one octave above the pitch of the cosine X wave. This is because you have this harmonic present in the Fourier polynomial. Because of this one, that's a lot louder than all the other coefficients. So that's going to be loud in the mix of the sound. So the one coefficient on the one sine 2x is going to make that part loud. And the sine 2x has 1/2 the period that cosine x does, because the 2 is accelerating the angles. Or you might remember 2 pi over b is the new period. So that'd be a period pi, whereas this one has a period of 2 pi. And thus it vibrates the speaker twice as fast and thus we hear a higher octave sound. So, a little bit digging into the details, the player site, at least the way it's sounding on my computer, is playing cosine x at 392 cycles per second. So that's 392 periods per second. So you just take that fundamental period, negative pi to pi, and you're copying and paste that, and you're playing that through the speaker 392 times per second. That's why you hear a pitch. Well, that happens to be about middle G on the piano. So that's 392 hertz. That's what cycle per second means. And so this harmonic, which is what these are actually called, these parts of this Fourier polynomial, they're actually called harmonics, and now you can realize why. They have half the period. This one has half the period of cosine x, so it has twice as many cycles per second. So it's actually playing at, that part is sounding at 784 hertz, up the octave from the 392. And the one coefficient on the sine 2x is making that loud in the sound, because one is a real high coefficient compared to the others. So it's loud in the mix. That's why we hear it. Notice that the sawtooth wave has more character in it than the square wave did on another video, or the cosine wave did. What if we could find the Fourier coefficients for one period of a violin sound being bowed? And if we put those in the player's sight, would it sound like a violin? Well, we'll find out. But basically, a violin is changing in character every moment of time, and we're going to try to capture just one period and cut and paste that. So we'll see. We'll see if it actually sounds like a violin, or maybe close, or who knows.